Now, in the book, Activate Heaven, I talk about your God-inspired unique voice. And I say here on page number 55, often God will inspire you to do something that is very unusual, something different, something that you've never really seen before, because as we discussed in the previous chapter, you are a unique individual with a unique voice and purpose. You have unique callings and talents. You will not do what everyone else does. You will do something very different, something new. God may send you out to pioneer in some area, but your knowing comes by inspiration. And so I love to teach on inspiration, or what I call inspired utterance, because there are utterances that are inspired by God. I'm amazed at the fact that on the day of Pentecost, the first thing that happens when they get filled with the Holy Spirit is they begin to speak in tongues. In other words, they begin to speak by inspiration. Speaking in tongues is inspired utterance in a language that you do not know. Prophecy is inspired utterance in a language that you do know. But notice the first thing that happens when they get baptized in the Holy Spirit is they begin to speak by inspiration. One of the definitions of a prophet or a prophetic person is really an inspired individual, one that speaks by inspiration. The prophets were moved by God to speak by inspiration. They were inspired by God to release the word of the Lord. An inspired utterances are very powerful, because when you speak by inspiration, you're speaking words that contain an anointing, contain power. Jesus said, "The words I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." And so Jesus spoke by inspiration. The prophets spoke by inspiration. And many times when you're praying in the spirit, when you're praying in tongues or singing in tongues or speaking in tongues and moving into that realm of inspiration, you'll begin to shift into English and begin to speak prophetically or pray prophetically or begin to speak by inspiration. Inspired utterances bring breakthrough. Thank you, Rashonda. Inspired utterances bring breakthrough. Miracles happen because of inspiration. In the beginning, God said, "Let there be light." And so in the beginning, God spoke and things began to change, and all creation came through speaking. And so God inspires us to speak. And remember, we're made in the image of God. And so we can also speak, but especially when you're filled with the Holy Ghost. John 7:37, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. To speak by inspiration, you'll begin to see miracles. God told Jeremiah in Jeremiah chapter 1, he says, "I put my word in your mouth that you might root out, that you might tear down, that you might destroy, that you might throw down, that you might build, and that you might plant." In other words, Jeremiah, when you speak the word that I put in your mouth, when you speak by inspiration, it's going to have the power to rip things out, to pull things down, to destroy things, but also to build things and to plant things. That's the power of inspiration, the power of inspired utterance. When you're moved by God to begin to speak. Now, many times when it comes to inspiration, one of the ways to begin to speak by inspiration is first to begin to speak in tongues or speak by the Spirit of God, and then shift into English. Because as you stir up the gift of God that is in you, you'll begin to see yourself speaking by inspiration. Prophecy, you can prophesy by inspiration. You can decree by inspiration. You can preach by inspiration. You can teach by inspiration. You can pray by inspiration. You can sing by inspiration. Inspired utterance is powerful because it's inspired by God and it's the inspiration of the Spirit of God. I would encourage you to do a word study on inspiration. You'll find some interesting verses, and I'm going to read some verses from the book of Job that talk about inspiration. Now, Job is a very interesting book because Job has three friends that come to him. And they begin to try to explain to him why he's going through what he's going through. His friends were Eliphaz, Bildad, and Zophar. Some of the things they said were not true. Even though the Bible is an inspired book, it was inspired by God to write it down. Some of the things they said were really not true because they were not speaking by inspiration. They were speaking by their own wisdom. And so they're debating with Job, and Job is actually disagreeing with them. One of them said, Job, you're in trouble because you've sinned. And Job was saying, no, I haven't done anything. I've been a righteous, perfect man. And so, but in as you get into Job chapter number 32, there's another individual that shows up. His name is Elihu, E-L-I-H-U. And he is a young man, and he waits until the older men speak out of respect for their age. And then when they finish speaking, he begins to speak. Now, this young man begins to speak by inspiration, and he really begins to be the person that Job wanted, someone that will be a spokesman for God. Job wanted to hear God's idea, God's mind. He was confused. He was under attack. He wanted a spokesman. And so God inspires this young man by the name of Elihu to begin to speak. I would encourage you to read the chapter where Elihu is speaking, because Elihu, even though he's younger, He begins to speak by inspiration. And he says this in Job 32, verses 18 through 20. Job 32, verses 18 through 20. He says, for I am full of matter. The spirit within me constraineth me. Behold, my belly is as wine which has no vent. It is ready to burst like new bottles. I will speak that I may be refreshed. I will open my lips and answer. Now, some translations say I'm full of words. The word matter there in the Hebrew means I'm full of words. In other words, as he's listening to the conversation between Job and his three friends, he begins to get a word, and it begins to rise up in him, and he's holding it. He says, it's like I've got a word like wine. It's building up, and it has no place to vent. And I'm about to explode. I've been holding it because I'm waiting on you guys to finish, but it's building up inside of me, and I've been holding it. And now it's my time to speak. It's my time to release what God has given me. That's sometimes the way the prophetic word operates. It can bubble up inside of you, and it can just build up and build up, and you don't have the opportunity, maybe in a service or at a particular time, to release it. Maybe you're in a prophetic service and you're working with other teams and they're prophesying and you're waiting your turn, and this thing is just building up, building up, building up, and you can't wait until your chance comes. And then when it comes, it just gushes out of you. It's like wine pouring out of you. It's like, because wine, what it does when it's put in a bottle, it begins to expand. That's why Jesus said you cannot put new wine in old bottles, because old bottles don't expand. They become rigid. They become hard. But new bottles are expandable. And wine, when it begins to ferment, it begins to expand. When you put it in an old bottle, it will burst the bottle because the bottle is not flexible. So many times with inspired utterance, it builds up inside of you. And then you begin to speak by inspiration. This is what Elihu was saying. I'm full of matter. I'm full of words. I'm full. I need to release this. And so he begins to speak by inspiration. And when you speak by inspiration, tremendous things begin to happen. That's why I talk in this book, Activate Heaven, about the power of your voice. But not only just speaking, but speaking by inspiration, speaking by the unction of God, speaking by the anointing of God, speaking when God breathes upon you, when you feel inspired to speak. And again, that can come through preaching, teaching, decreeing, prophesying. There are times on this broadcast when I'm decreeing and God will inspire me to decree another verse of scripture that I haven't even decreed before. It comes by inspiration. And when you begin to do that, you begin to see real breakthroughs, because inspired words carry power. Inspired words carry the anointing. Inspired words release breakthrough and miracles. And that's what prophets did. They spoke by inspiration. They were inspired by God. And when they prophesied, things happened. When they prophesied, things shifted, things changed because of the power of inspired utterance. Now, you can talk all day. People can talk all day. People are talking all day. It doesn't mean that their words carry any power. The scripture says, how forcible are right words when you speak the right word, when you speak by inspiration. So we need to learn how to be inspirated people, people that's, I don't even know there's a word called inspirated, but we become people of inspiration. We're prophetic people. We're inspired people. To be prophetic simply means you operate by inspiration. You don't shut it down. You don't hold it back. You don't quench it. Quench not the spirit, but you allow, despise not prophesying. You allow the release of that word, because when words are inspired by God, they can bring edification, exhortation, comfort, deliverance, breakthrough, healing, miracle, strength, glory. It's just an amazing operation of God through you speaking. Inspired utterance is when God anoints you to be his spokesman. And when God speaks, something happened. I've written a book called God Still Speaks. When God speaks through us by inspiration, by the unction, by the anointing of God, by the spirit of God, things happen. Just as God spoke in the beginning and light came and the world was framed by the word of the Lord, the voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The voice of the Lord causes the hinds to calve in Psalms 29. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The voice of the Lord brings breakthrough and brings miracles. And when you learn the power of inspiration, don't quench it. Don't put it down. Don't bottle it up. Learn how to speak it. Learn how to release the word of the Lord through your voice, because that's the key to walking in miracles and walking in breakthrough. When the anointing comes on you, or the anointing bubbles up inside of you, two words for prophesy are naba or nabi, which means to bubble up, and nataf, which means to fall upon. Two different operations of the prophetic. And I have a book also called The Prophet's Manual that talks about these different operations of the prophetic that I would encourage you to order. And this is one of my favorite subjects, because inspired utterances in 1 Corinthians, God said to Paul, I want you to abound in utterance. I pray that you would abound in utterance. Utterance is very important. Sometimes the enemy wants to put a muzzle on your mouth, wants you to draw back. I'm not going to speak anymore. Like Jeremiah said, I'm not going to prophesy anymore. But then he said, the word was in me like fire shut up in my bones. Sometimes because of disappointment, hurt, setbacks, you say, I'm not going to speak. I'm not going to say anything. I'm just going to hold my peace. And that's one of the worst things you can do. Now, there is a time to hold your peace. There is a time to be silent, but then there's a time to speak, because when you speak by inspiration, miracles and breakthroughs will begin to happen in your life. So I pray now for those who are watching that you'll begin to understand the power of inspiration, the power of inspired utterance, and that you'll begin to speak by inspiration. And I come against any demon in your life that would come to muzzle you or shut you down or cause you to be afraid to speak. When you feel the stirring and unction of God, you won't release it. You hold on to it. And I pray that God will release you to begin to speak as the oracle of God, to begin to speak those divine mysteries, those divine words. When they come out of your mouth, let there be breakthroughs and miracles and healings and signs and wonders happen even this year and years to come. May you know the power of your voice. The power of your voice, the power of your voice. In this book, I subtitle it, use the power of your voice to win battles and walk in favor. When you get a revelation of the power of your voice, some people don't even like their voice. They when they hear themselves, even on a recording, they say that doesn't sound right, because when you speak, you hear yourself through your inner ear. But when others hear you, they hear you differently. And some people don't even like their voice, but God gave you a unique voice. Everyone has a different voice. No two people have the same voice. 8 billion people on the planet, and everyone has a unique voice, because your voice is like your fingerprint. And so when you're inspired, God uses your voice. God uses your voice, your tongue, your words to release things in the earth. So use your voice. Don't let the enemy shut your voice down. Don't you shut your voice down. Open your mouth. Begin to declare. Begin to decree. That's why every day I come on this broadcast, I decree. I decree, I decree, because I know that when you decree, when you decree by the unction and by the anointing of God, that supernatural things begin to happen. Your future begins to change. You begin to walk in destiny and purpose. Things begin to shift and transform in your life. You cannot afford to be depressed and sad and sit somewhere alone and crying and weeping and just not saying anything. No, rise up. God says, my word is like a hammer that breaks the rock in pieces. The word is his word is sharp and quick, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit and of the joints and marrow, and as a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. The word in your tongue, in your mouth, when you speak as the oracle of God, you'll see miracles and breakthroughs and the purposes and plans of God released in the earth. God does nothing but that he first reveals it unto his servants, the prophets. God always speaks it first. And again, Isaiah 42:9, behold, the former things have come to pass, and new things do I declare before they spring forth. I tell you of them. God always declares it. He declares the end from the beginning. God is a God of declaration. God is a God that speaks. God is a God that gives voice to his plans and purposes. God is a God that inspires us and moves us. And when you get filled with the Holy Ghost, you begin to speak in tongues, because that is inspired utterance. The first thing that God gets a hold of when he comes and fills you is your tongue. Why? Because your tongue is the rudder of the ship. Your tongue is what takes you into your future, into your destiny. When you speak as the oracle of God, when you speak and release the word of the Lord. So I pray for your tongue. I pray for your mouth. I pray for your lips to be anointed. I pray for fresh oil to come into your mouth. If you're a preacher, a teacher, an intercessor, a singer, a psalmist, if you decree, if you speak, if you're a public speaker, if you speak, if you counsel, I pray for a new anointing to drop in your lips, in your tongue, and in your mouth, that when you speak, you'll release grace and healing and deliverance and breakthrough and miracles as you speak. I pray that this year will be a year of the mouth, that when you speak, miracles will happen. Excuse me, signs and wonders will happen, breakthroughs will happen, things will shift and change in your life. It'll be a new season, a breakthrough for you. I pray that God would raise up prophetic, inspired people all over the world, that they'll begin to speak. And when they speak, mountains will be removed. Things will shift and change. Walls will come down. Breakthroughs will occur. Miracles shall be released. Finances shall be released. New things shall be released. The plans of God shall be activated. There'll be voice activated because you'll speak as the oracle of God. Father, I bless everyone that is watching. And I pray that they'll be like Elihu. They'll be full of your word, full of inspired utterances, and they'll release it out. It'll be like a vent. It'll come out. It may build up, but it'll be like wine venting, pouring out of their mouth. Let the wine flow. Wine represents the Spirit of God. Let the wine be released. Let you speak as wine flowing, and let that wine bring joy and healing and a move of the Spirit of God. Let you be like a bottle, a new bottle that carries new wine. And when that wine begins to build up, it'll flow out of your mouth. Let honey and milk and wine flow from your lips to bring healing and nourishment and miracles through your tongue and through your lips. Let your tongue and your mouth be anointed with milk and butter and honey, and let wine flow, and let water flow, and let rivers flow, and let life flow out of your mouth, out of your tongue. Father, I thank you that our words will be like butter, our words will be like milk, our words will be like honey, our words will be like wine that bring healing and nourishment and blessing and deliverance wherever we go. Father, do it. I pray. I release it now over those who are watching and those who are listening in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Well, I hope you received that word. Don't forget, if you want a copy of this book, you can order it at Amazon.com, ChristianBooks.com. Remember, when I say activate heaven, Psalms 19, the heavens declare, we are heavenly people. We're heaven, we represent heaven. So when we declare, the heavens declare the glory of God. We're on earth, but we represent a heavenly kingdom. And so that's the premise of this book. If you want a signed copy, go to johneckhardt.global and order a book that way. We'll send you a signed copy.